And welcome back to the Tarot Cottage. My name is Amy. I'm back today with a pick a card reading for you. Welcome to my beautiful returning subscribers. Thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you so much to everyone who has dropped a comment below any of my videos this month. Be sure to check your notification bell. I'm waiting back to hear from my most recent winner, and a congratulations to last week's winner as well. If you are here for the very first time, I do pick a card readings on this channel, so please pull up and get cozy. We're gonna have a little chat today because we're all friends when we gather around this table. For today's topic, though, we're looking at the connection on your mind and their true feelings for you. Is it lust or is it love? How does this person truly feel for you at this moment in time? We do have three piles to choose from. Pile number one here with the Santi Morte Book of the Dead Tarot and this piece of carnelian palm. Pile number two with the Halloween Tarot and the blue aragonite. And pile number three with the Panda Tarot and the... that called? I believe it's called Malachite, I believe. So whichever pile or piles are calling out to you, there may be a message waiting today from Spirit, and my timestamps are listed below. I'm going to jump into pile number one. Today we're asking the question, is it lust or is it love? How does the person on your mind truly feel about you right this moment? Pile one. Hello, pile number one. You were drawn to the red carnelian palm or to the Santi Morte Book of the Dead Tarot, and this is your reading. Is it love or is it lust that the person on your mind feels for you currently? How does this person currently feel about you, pile number one? Is it love or is it lust for pile number one, please? So we have the Lovers coming out with the Five of Cups here. Now, the Lovers is a card of connection for sure, but it can also be very lusty, actually, and it's connected with all of this emotion. And you'll notice here with the Five of Cups that their mind must be amazed, which means that they're ruminating over and over about you and decisions that they made or are currently making in response to how they feel about you. How do they truly feel, please, Spirit? Is it lust or is it love? We have the Six of Pentacles. And they're really kind of kicking themselves for the choices that they've made overall when it comes to your connection. There could be a work connection here for someone watching, but it doesn't have to be. I feel like there could be attachments for this person, or in the very least insecurity, but it could be actual practical attachments. We have the Five of Pentacles. And they feel separated from you. So this could be a no contact, for instance. It could just be an emotional separation, but it does feel like it's in a physical separation. And it feels like it could have been going on for some time as well, because they're really emphasizing the amount of time they've had to think about this situation. And there's the King of Wands. Back of the deck is the Nine of Cups. And we have the Four of Wands. And I want to clarify this as we go forward here. Is it lust or love? How do they truly feel about pile number one? Now, the Nine of Cups is a wish fulfillment energy. Somebody who is wishing upon you, perhaps in a very fiery way, to be honest, but there's so much connection surrounding the Four of Wands, even the Lover's energy, that this energy surrounding a wishful thinking surrounding you could be because they feel like you're out of reach. And they're very regretful about wearing masks around you in the past and not being honest with their true feelings about you in the past as well. You have the Death Cycle. And the Ace of Wands. I feel like this person is very lusty towards you, pile one, because they haven't had the opportunity to move it into the emotional realm. It's like that feels like a safe zone for them to focus upon in this moment, because they are filled with remorse or loss when it comes to you. But they're really emphasizing the practical loss of you and how they're feeling really emotionally unfulfilled because they have never had a chance to see where this path could lead them. So they're very, very lusty towards you, but they also feel like that could have been a prompt or a doorway to something way bigger or way, way stronger. Because I feel like their connection, this connection that they feel for you lies way deeper than just fire, but they want fire. Like they're very, very triggered by thoughts of you. They're very perhaps turned on by thoughts of you. This Ace of Wands in the center of the reading competes with their responsibilities and competes with their focus. And it feels like they're really crushing hard on you. Like you feel like they can't, you feel like somebody that they can't have, or you're out of reach in some way. And in the very least, they don't know how you feel. And so they're really concerned about bridging that gap. Here with the Six of Swords, there's the Two of Swords and there's the Two of Wands. I feel like they focus on fire, to be honest with you, to protect their heart space from the impeding emotional damage that could come in because of the loss, because of the separation. So they may choose to focus upon fire, upon something they've never had with you, or upon something that they have had with you that they really enjoyed. But it almost feels like very, it feels almost like they haven't had that experience with you. And so they're choosing to focus that. Because otherwise, this Page of Wands is connected to the Eight of Cups. Otherwise, they would find the overall experience very unfulfilling and very emotionally taxing in the very least. I feel like this person wishes that they had clarity over how you feel too, because they feel kind of stuck in their own perspective because they don't have privy information to how you feel or what your perspective is in the situation. And they really kick themselves a lot when it comes to not being able to achieve what they wanted with you or take the mask off the way that they should have. And they're blaming themselves. And I do feel like a lot of their complications in the practical realm are very different from just the fear factor that they were competing against when it came to revealing themselves in the past. Now there are practical things at play, perhaps. There are other people, maybe jobs, careers, just other dynamics at play that now compete with that. And they are being very passive. We have I ruin everything I touch. And I'm getting over my fears, the Nine of Swords, the overthinking. And this is the Seven of Swords of somebody who's not being honest with themselves. So even when we have the passion showing itself, it's not true passion. It's blocking something else. It's keeping our focus away from the emotion that is there because they feel the connection to you with the Four of Wands. But they also, again, it's competing with something practical. There could be family units at play here. I thought that I had more time to express themselves to you in the past. We have Yin. And I want to grow old with you. The Ten of Pentacles coming in the reversal. I do feel like there could, for someone watching, and this may not resonate with everyone, but for someone watching, this person may have a family at this time. Because they're worried about coming forward with their truth or letting this spark carry them forward. They're worried about a death cycle. They're worried about perhaps a foreclosure in a relationship. And it says, I know you feel the same, but that came out reversed because they don't know. They feel like it's wishful thinking, and there's almost a if pigs could fly mentality coming through. They feel like it's very risky when it comes to taking action towards you, and they are very, very focused on fire. But as I said, pile one, I don't feel like it's solely fire. I feel like this fire is what they allow themselves to focus on because the emotional wave would be too unsatisfying. And so they do use fire to empower themselves in some way when it comes to this connection. How do they truly feel these about pile number one? We have here, sometimes life stings, the wasp spirit. And there is unfinished cycles here, and it stings them to not be able to achieve sort of what they want here in the fire realm with you. They are kicking themselves. They thought that they had more time. They wish they had made better choices, I feel like, as well. But their peacock spirit, let it shine. It's like we have to look beyond the immediate appearances to see where this person is coming from. And this peacock, which is very much in relation to the King of Pentacles or the Knight of Pentacles, who is responsible perhaps for something practical, he's leading from the heart space. There's this light coming out of the heart space here. And we have here, be loyal to what you love, the dog spirit, number 19. And that's the truth of the matter. That's what is really showing itself in this clarifying position, is this is the Sun. This could be a friendship from the past. They're very loyal to that respect or to that connection from the past. And we have to look beyond what they're showing us in the present realm to see the truth behind the emotion. So the spark is just hiding a flood of emotion at this time. But they're like, snake spirit, I'm on guard, I'm trying to heal, number 55. And they're still having a hard time overcoming that hurdle, which is why they're so guarded and why this connection feels perhaps dangerous in the emotional realm. Truly feel this present moment, please. Towards pile number one. Is it lust or love? We have mysticism. And you, I feel like you are a mystery. And I wish that they could peel back the layers to how you feel. And it feels like you're, and this, they may be the same for you as well. It's like there's this shoulda, coulda, woulda mentality surrounding this connection. We have renewal. Back of the deck is discovery. And I will say that there's this process of them in the healing aspect when it comes to your connection, how they perhaps are trying to move through this cycle, but they're still holding on to this spark. Despite the fact that there could have been years, they're still holding on to this spark. There's something about the spark that makes them feel, even though there's a separation, makes them feel still close to you or connected to you in some way. Their current thoughts, please. Is it lust or is it love? I wish that I'd been more honest with you. And I'm losing hope. The truth is that they want a new beginning, but it feels like a perfect world scenario. And it feels like something that they would have to really practically put into play. You consume my thoughts. And it's very fiery energy. And no one knows I still think about you. So they are wearing heavy, heavy masks. I miss you regardless of how things look on the outside. So even though they're showing us a lot of fiery energy, pile one, there is an emotional attachment that this person does still feel to you or feel towards you. But it almost feels like innocent in nature and they want to explore even that as well. It's like they want to deepen all of these aspects, deepen the connection with you physically, and tap into the emotional connection that they're still feeling with you. It does feel sort of like they think that they're. It does feel like it's a separation. Advice, please. The last thought that this person had about pile number one in the bowl. We have the Nine of Swords. They were dreaming perhaps about you or losing sleep. They were thinking about the past and the ways in which they have failed themselves or failed the connection in some way. And that's what we mean when we're talking about overthinking, that if this was all lusty energy, it wouldn't just be air in the bowl. There would be fire in the bowl too. But it's like they're torturing themselves with these thoughts, looking into the background. And this person with the swords, if they keep doing that, they're going to hurt themselves. They're going to fall on their face. So this person is very reflective when it comes to you. And they've had epiphanies when it comes to your connection as well. And I feel like they had these epiphanies because they perhaps have moved into other timelines and they've experienced relationships, and it pales into comparison to what they felt with the beginnings of this connection in the past. I do feel like they think about wanting to go back to the past and or wanting to go back to the drawing board and start again. We have Sun, clarity, Leo energy. We have P and E and W. I think of a cardinal every time I see that. I see pew pew, I think of a cardinal. We have here the moon with the fairy. I think of something that I'm wishing for that I don't know if it exists. So it's like they're wishing upon you. The leaf of change. We have the stethoscope, looking at things through the heart space. Could be a blocked heart chakra. Or hospital nursing connection. Cancer energy. We have the dolphin. I think of playfulness and friendship, reunions, and we have the blank canvas. So somebody who is taking creative accountability, or they're taking accountability for what has happened in this connection or what has not happened. All right, dear, that's what I have for you today. I hope that it resonates with you. If it did, drop your comment below for a chance to win a free reading with me. You can also check out my links below for Etsy for a personal reading if you feel called to. But I hope that you come back here and visit me at the Tarot Cottage, and I hope you have a great day. Hello, pile number two. You are drawn to the blue aragonite, or to the Halloween tarot, and this is your reading. Is the person on your mind interested in lust or love when it comes to you and this connection? So how do they truly feel right this moment? Please, for pile number two, is it lust or is it love that they are feeling primarily? Is it lust or is it love, please, for pile number two? We have the Nine of Cups coming out. Now, the Nine of Cups is, and this is very similar to pile one, only theirs was the back of deck, but there's an aspect of a wish fulfillment, crushing energy. It's like maybe they would feel very smug with you on their arm. We have Temperance. We have the King of Pentacles. They could be a Taurus, a Virgo, a Capricorn. We have the Page of Cups. We have the Moon, and we have the Two of Swords. Back of the deck, we have the Tower, and we have the Five of Wands. Now, I'm going to clarify this as we go forward. What's interesting about this message for you, pile two, is that the Tower here, you can see it's like blowing the top, the lid off of this haunted house. There's all of these ghosts coming out of the house, and they keep emphasizing the ghosts surrounding this person on your mind. And I don't want to, there's a definite aspect of this person being very interested in physically mixing with you. Like, there just is. I feel like this person sometimes distracts themselves with the lusty realm to avoid some of their own internalized energy, because they're really showing that this person has like a fear of commitment, or they're not ready for commitments, or they're not ready to open up their heart space. They could actually be a Scorpio energy, because it's like they are late to the party in some way, or they feel like they're late to the party when it comes to opening up that heart space. Being emotionally driven is too vulnerable for this person. So there is a bit of a reality surrounding their perspective right now. Now, the truth is that this opportunity with you serves as an opportunity for this person to evolve past that fiery stage and into something more emotionally driven. But it's like they are really afraid of turning that chapter or allowing emotion to come in, because then it feels permanent. It feels like there's no going back. We have the Nine of Swords. And so they operate off of what they know. They operate off of what they feel comfortable. And they feel comfortable in the physical realm. And they feel comfortable maintaining that for a while as well. We have the Two of Cups. Now, that's not to say that this won't eventually evolve into a full-fledged relationship. But they are very much fixated on fire in a very self-protective mode as well. And I will say that Spirit is saying that they're actually tied down by their own perspective in the practical realm, because they keep saying they're yoked. That's what he keeps saying. They're yoked right now. They're being tied down. We have the Five of Wands. And they're just this person. I feel like they're a really good looking person too. I almost feel like they're a bit of a collector, because that's where they would perhaps get some of their ego strength, is from the people that find them attractive, or the people that they would attract themselves. Because they're in a very restless stage of their life, and they won't always be this way, but they're in a very restless stage of their life. We have the Five of Swords. And I will say that emotional concepts or emotion, even when their higher self tries to influence them with emotion, I feel like that makes them uncomfortable. I feel like they almost gaslight themselves out of that emotion in some way, because they're very self-protective of their own heart space. And they prioritize their own heart space, I will say that. Not because they're a bad person, but because this is the stage of life that they're in right now. Very lusty stage. And Spirit doesn't want you to take this as an internalized conflict that there's something wrong with you, or that you're not enough to shift that gaze. Because that's not the case. You are amazing. And they don't want you to jump to that conclusion. But they are saying that this person is the type of person that's running with their perspective right now. You know, it's like they don't want to see a new perspective in this present moment, because that will make them go inward and make them feel vulnerable, and they're not quite ready for that. We have the Justice. Back of the deck is the Star. And we have the Ten of Wands. They're even saying that they're kind of burdened by their own fire here, or burdened by their own focus, because it is holding them back from seeing the truth, seeing something really positive, perhaps, or really being able to, again, evolve. Because when we are evolving as spiritual beings, we do it through vulnerability, and that's what they're trying to avoid by keeping their focus on the lusty realm with you, Pile Two. So again, it's not a testament to who you are. You're the Star of Aquarius. You could be the energy that is there to kind of tempt them or lull them into a new perspective, into permanent change, but they're trying to avoid it in this present moment, and they are still very much focused in this spread on lusty energy towards you. Very, very attracted to you in the present moment. How do they currently feel, please? Lust or love energy towards pile number two. We have deception. Someone is wearing a false mask in this relationship. And they could be acting very suave and very emotionally vulnerable in the present moment. We have here chemistry. There is a strong magnetic attraction here. And Spirit's not saying you shouldn't go after this attraction. If you feel it and you want to pursue it, they say go ahead. They're saying finances and career are a factor right now for this person. So they could just be very much focused on building for themselves and not really trying to focus on the emotional development right now. Also have past life relationship. You've known each other before. And back the deck says, stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. And I do feel like this could progress. The two of you could continue to see each other perhaps in the future. And this could progress towards new doorways. But in the present, Spirit says that there is a very lusty vibe between the two of you. Just saw the community card. We have a round and round and round. It could be that this person's kind of stuck in that rumination cycle. And it could be that this person keeps coming back around as well. The ghosts from the past, this person could keep coming back around to your experience as well. We have here poised, reversed. And the poise comes in reverse, like the Fool reverse, who doesn't feel ready or they're ill-equipped to jump into an emotional connection here. But it's like this connection brings them to the very edge. Brings them to the very edge, and it encourages them. It kind of coaxes them because they are very, very attracted to you. In almost like a they're way too good for me sort of way. Very attracted to you. But they are struggling against their own hurdles in the present moment. How does this person currently feel, please, about pile number two? Are they lusty thoughts? Are they loving thoughts? I've thought about having a family with you. I'm so attracted to you. You do not know what you do to me. This person has also considered the possibilities of more with you as well. They're just not at that stage of commitment at this time to move into anything more emotionally abundant. I've been telepathically communicating with you. Some people don't want to see us together, but I don't care. So it could be that other people don't really like maybe friends don't really like the way that this person acts, or maybe they are some type of collector. I have a gift for you, very generous energy, and I've been astral projecting to you. So this person could be dreaming about you as well. How do they currently feel, please, about pile number two? Is it lusty energy or loving energy? We have Panther Spirit, reclaim your power. It's coming in reversed. And I think of the Panther Spirit as like an unlikely ally. I also think about somebody who's watching from the darkness, who wants something. You know, they're watching with intention. And we have Fox Spirit, think on your feet. Number 27. Back of the deck is the Otter Spirit. You are never alone. It's number 42. It's coming in reverse. And I think of the Otter Spirit as a very emotionally driven animal, a very family-oriented creature too. There could have been something that happened in the past with this person's family or parents that contribute to their fear of vulnerability coming forward. So please take that as it resonates. It's not for everyone. Let's get a couple of message cards. What were their last thoughts, please? What are they thinking when it comes to their feelings? Towards pile two, are they lusty or loving thoughts? We were friends first, and I miss that. I want you so badly. So very lusty energy here. I can still hear your laugh. I'm haunted by this connection, which is interesting because we have all of these ghosts that are flying around the deck that you chose, pile two. And we have a wake-up call, and thus the tower as well. And so there is this feeling about, you know, you walking away, of them howling at that moon and recognizing that there is something special about you, but it's triggering them. It's triggering them to overcome this hurdle. And that's where they're struggling, is to overcome that hurdle and to open up that heart space. Back of the deck says, we're not on the same level and I do not deserve you. And that's the Nine of Cups that we saw, the star energy as well, pile two. Let's get a charm bowl, please, for pile number two. The last thought this person had about pile two in the bowl. The Three of Wands, very fiery energy. There's the King of Pentacles. They definitely could be an earth energy here. And there's the Lover. So very fiery thoughts for you, pile two. So very lusty energy presently from the person on your mind, wanting expansion, wanting physical connection. The Lovers is all a card of choice as well. Can talk about moral choices, choices between people, exercising their options. We have the Snake of Temptation. We have the V for Hierophant, could be an initial. We do have the pickaxe, I think, about chipping away at a cool exterior. And we have the Three of Swords. So there could be other people that this person is entertaining, or there could be other people, like option energy. We have find joy in the journey, and that's temperance energy. And we had that in your spread because this person does want to be like the alchemist and mix together. And it's like they want to spend time with you without worrying about the consequences of the forevers. You are very highly thought of, though, here with the Minnie Mouse bow. We do have the Divine Feminine with the ring around it, so you could be interested in commitment cycles. And here is the lightning bolt from the tower. Here is the book that's flipped over, I think, of an open book. So somebody who's keeping a bit of secrets, or somebody who doesn't share everything that's in their heart space. We also have the anchor. Pile two, that's what I have for you today. I hope it resonates with you. If it did, drop your comment below for a chance to win a free reading with me. You can also check out my links below for Etsy for a personal reading or for Instagram. But please come back and visit me at the Tarot Cottage, and I hope you have a great day. Hello, pile number three. You are drawn to the green malachite, or to the panda tarot, and this is your reading. Is it lust or is it love, the feelings that the person on your mind has towards you, pile three? Are they more lust driven towards you, or are they feeling an emotional connection towards the other person? So let's see. At this present moment, and you know, feelings ebb and change, of course, so we're looking at present energy only. Is it lust or is it love that this person currently feels for pile number three, please? We have the Ace of Pentacles. We also have the Queen of Cups coming out. We have the Lovers. We have the Five of Pentacles coming sideways. We'll have to remember that. We have the Page of Wands. And the Seven of Wands. Back of the deck is the Fool, and we also have the Tower. We're going to clarify this as we go forward here. Let's clarify this reading. The Divine Feminine here could be a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. We also have Gemini, very strong here as well. We have the Ten of Cups, and I'm feeling a very strong motherhood energy surrounding the Divine Feminine. So you perhaps are a parent already, or you have goals to be a parent or to have that as a part of your fulfillment cycle. We have the Eight of Cups. And they are saying that there is a very strong emphasis on the Divine Feminine's heart space. It's like she really wants this to be an opportunity for her. It's like we have our hopes set here. We have the Three of Cups. The Seven of Wands. And we have the Eight of Swords. Back of the deck is the King of Swords. The person that you're dealing with could definitely be the Gemini. Here we also have the Page of Pentacles. Now, what's interesting here is that Spirit's talking about this as an opportunity for growth in this connection. And there are obstacles to sort of achieving the overall goals the Divine Feminine has here to sort of fulfilling this Ten of Cups. So whatever that encompasses to you, it could be family, could be just emotional support and abundance. This is an opportunity that's starting the process here. And I feel like you're still learning about each other. You're building that rapport in some way. I will say that in the present moment, there is a very, very strong emphasis on having fun and fire and, physical connection with you. I would be lying if I ignored the lovers, the Page of Wands, the Seven of Wands. These even here with the Page and the Seven, that's the Eight of Wands. It's a very fiery connection. And this person's focus in this present moment is definitely on doing something risky with you, doing something fiery when it comes to you. And it's on having fun in the present moment. But there is this aspect about this momentum that this creates. And even here with this card, it's like this momentum that it creates into movement. Even this card looks like it's extending into the Seven of Wands, and how we can use the fire realm to break down barriers and move into a more of an emotional state. But in the present realm, they are very focused on fire. And I also feel like for someone watching, there's this emphasis on being afraid of losing something practical if I really extend myself emotionally. It's like somebody's worried about practical losses. And this could be coming from the Divine Feminine. Again, if she has children, you could have a lot of people that you're concerned about moving into this connection. There's a very protective element surrounding the Divine Feminine. And Spirit, again, this is the message that has come across the board for all three piles, that if anybody doesn't have a focus on you, that's the way that you want them to focus on you. So if they're not feeling the loving energy or connection that you're feeling, that doesn't communicate anything about you or your value. It communicates everything about their readiness and their availability for that emotional gaze or scope. Because I just feel like either this person's not ready for a relationship, or maybe there's already relationships in place that don't allow them to really go into an emotional development with you at this time. There's just some obstacles getting in the way of them bridging that gap between having fun and emotional development. And in the present moment, they are enjoying your company. There's something different about you. If you guys are going out together, they enjoy that. And they want to continue to fuel that curiosity. And as I said, fueling that curiosity could just be exactly the toolkit that we need to break through these prisons. We don't have to invest in that. We don't have to involve ourselves if we choose not to. But it is very fiery. It is very, very fiery at this time. As I said, this could lead to permanent change. This could lead to this tower energy. And this tower energy looks a lot different for everybody watching because I'm dealing with the collective energy. For some, this tower is permanent change leading to a commitment, perhaps an emotional development. For some, again, if there are other practical things in place for someone watching, this tower could mean the end of those practicalities. But in the present realm, this person is very, very focused on attachments in the physical nature. And I will say, again, as for somebody watching, not for everyone, but for somebody watching, there's actual physical attachments that are a part of these obstacles from bridging that gap between having fun and fire and moving into something more emotionally invested with you, moving into a relationship. I feel like they're not able to, or they're not ready for a relationship at this time. Feel, please, to lust or love. And it's almost like they won't allow themselves to take the risk of looking at you in an emotional scape, otherwise, or scope. Otherwise, they're really going to be opening up a can of worms for themselves in some way. We have here trust. The situation is calling for you to have faith, because they are talking about it being a transitionary energy, and how more information and seeking out more information in this connection can help you to achieve full clarity over their perspective or achieve some goals that you have overall. We do have religious factors coming out here and honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. Now, I will say that for someone watching, and I can't ignore the message, that this person could be attached or you could be attached. There could be some attachments here to other people because the religious factors card has come out, and that's somebody who may be already invested in a commitment of some kind, but it's not an emotional commitment. It may just be sort of an arrangement or a practical connection at this time, and they want to whisk you away to sort of a secret location, a very lusty energy to whisk you away to a secret location. So that could sort of correspond with some of the obstacles that you're facing in this connection, because this person's really relying on their own logic and on their own focus to keep themselves out of the risky business of feeling something emotional for you in the present moment. There is an aspect here of somebody in this connection using this physical connection to empower themselves in some way. Either empower their ego, empower their sense of momentum, because the Eight of Cups is all about moving away from unfulfilling cycles. We do have breathe coming out here. Number 29 breaks down to an 11. And the 11's all about the justice, about the truth, again, Libra energy. And somebody who is afraid perhaps of the cause and effect of their own actions towards you. So they're taking a breather. They are spending some time suspended above the emotion on the lily pad. I keep seeing the Y card as well. And we have Observer. Back of the deck is the Soulmate reversed here, number 41. And the Observer energy, they see so much potential, but this is a very sort of logically minded person. Like, they think about the consequences of things. They think about the Tower consequences. And so it's like they're keeping their emotions at bay for now, purposefully. It feels like an intentional energy. How are they currently feeling? Please, love or lust for pile number 3. We have Whale, trust the great mystery. The 65, and I again, breaks down to an 11. And the Whale, somebody who's afraid to express themselves because they feel like it's risky. They're worried to express themselves in a really emotional way. We have trust in the magic with the White Raven spirit. And we have the Dragonfly spirit, truth transcends illusion. And there is an aspect here about if this person were completely 100% honest with themselves, that there is a trickling of emotion and connection sinking into the connection. But it's encouraging them to change directions in some way, whether it be towards you or in their environment. And they're worried about the ability to have the confidence and the strength to power through the necessary steps to create change with you. Whoopsie. What sort of thoughts does this person have? Pile number 3. Is it lusty or is it loving thoughts coming through, please? I'm focused on me right now, the Knight of Wands. The Knight of Wands doesn't want to worry about his forevers. The Knight of Wands wants to go rushing in with what he wants in the present moment. He wants to be very impulsive, wants to be risky. I see things clearly now, the Sun. And I should have ran after you. The Five of Swords, the Five of Cups. And that's the aspect here, is that this person ultimately could be worried about missing out if they don't take the steps that they're guided to take in your connection. Because it's like their lusty energy towards you is also combined with some feelings of remorse, feelings of loss. And as long as they're focusing on that Three of Cups, they don't have to focus on sort of the steps they have to take to achieve the relationship. I didn't want you to rely on me, the Three of Pentacles. It's like they don't want you to rely on them as you build upon a foundation because they have a lot of responsibilities already on their plate. And I'm scared. I'm getting over my fears. I'm overthinking. And when we're overthinking, we can't really hone down one singular feeling that we're having. We have here, I'm tired of holding back, the Four of Swords, and somebody who just wants to return to the world. I think about you when I'm all alone. Very lusty energy towards you, pile three. I made so many wrong decisions when it came to you. I just saw I loved you then, I loved you still, I always have, I always will. Whenever I see that quote, I think about marriages, so please take that as it resonates. What are you doing right now? And do I think about you too much? So a little bit of obsessive thoughts. I'll get a couple more. Obsessive thoughts when it comes to you. The attraction is undeniable. And I am sorry if I hurt you. Back of the deck says, you are my happy place. So they escape to you. They escape to thoughts of you. They escape to you perhaps as well, pile three. But it does feel very, very lusty in this present moment. And I feel like they're afraid of that. They're afraid of change when it comes to emotional development. What is the very last thought they had about pile number three in the bowl, please? Nine of Cups, wishful thinking, smug energy as well, the Four of Swords, and the Five of Cups reversed. They were really thinking about the practicalities and about the truth behind the obstacles. What was holding them back? And there's almost a remorse energy of like wanting forgiveness from you when it comes to being passive or taking a passive approach or needing forgiveness because of how they feel in this connection and wishing that they could make change now and not have to wait for it. In the bowl today, we have the letters W and K, work connection perhaps. We also have a group of grapes, and I think about the Three of Cups and going out and having fun. We also have the turtle, I think responsibilities, integrity. We do have the strawberry, I think of summertime, and I think of the Star of Aquarius. So Aquarius energy could be significant. Also think of temptation. We have the blue kitty cat. I think of somebody who wants to claim their independence. I also think about Leo energy and somebody who feels stuck perhaps in their position. We have here, I am the Lord thy God. For a commandment, we have forever. And so somebody who may have made commitments. We have the Nine of Wands, someone who is holding back. And the Nine of Wands is also about frustration, frustrating delay, somebody who has been holding wands or sparks towards you for a long time and has nowhere to direct them. And then we have kind, brave, free, strong, happy, thankful. These are all beautiful qualities that you possess. Pile number three, that's what I have for you today. I hope it resonates with you. If it did, drop your comment below for a chance to win a reading with me. Be sure to hit your notification bell if you do so. You can also check out my links for Instagram or for Etsy for a personal reading if you feel called to. But I hope that you come and visit me at the Tarot Cottage, and I hope you have a great day.